Upper Peninsula, the healthcare component of our regional economy can't be overemphasized. Our healthcare institutions collectively are easily the largest employers in the UP. And healthcare jobs touch just about every aspect of the overall economy and our quality of life in the Upper Peninsula.
Patients are leaving the Upper Peninsula at a staggering pace. I'm not sure if the economic folks in this room understand that $100 million of out-migration occurs every year into the state of Wisconsin from the Upper Peninsula. $100 million is a lot of money. That translates to lost jobs and lost tax revenue. That's the economic impact. But what about the patient impact? For patients and their families who have to leave the UP and drive someplace else for health care, it just isn't appropriate and it's not consistent with our mission.
We feel, vision there again, that successful ACOs will be rewarded financially. In other words, this is not, if you all remember back in the, it was the 80s. No, it was the 70s, 1970s.
I know you do.
My first job in healthcare was with a feasibility study for an HMO in Florida. And the HMO concept was prepay, defined population, everybody get preventive health care, and everybody's going to get well. Well, that didn't work. But what we feel now is that with an ACO, there will be defined population, there will be money, but the reward will be on quality rather than basically a prepaid per patient. So the successful ACOs will manage that money well while improving care. What that does, we feel, with what Rick mentioned, the $100 million leaking out of the UP annually, that will allow us to make people stay at home, don't go anywhere other than what we can't do. And then we manage that money and improve the care at the same time.
First of all, congratulations. Obviously, regionalism and collaboration is going to be very important in the future, and to have your sector take the first step in doing that, I applaud you. But I would be remiss if I didn't ask the question of the $100 million that's leaving the Upper Peninsula. What do you think we realistically can retain and grow back here in the Upper Peninsula? And how does that translate to number of jobs?
I'll take a stab only in that. We don't know.
Lie to me big. Big numbers.
Quite honestly, the doctors are the key. And we have physician groups that are working together already. We have data. The data you saw is just tip of the iceberg. We can drill down to specialty, county, where it's going, all this. And we already have things that will address all those. If we can get 25% of $100 million a year, it's $25 million, that would probably be a couple hundred jobs.
I'm good with that.